Page 2 in lesson 2. We're going to move now from area of parallelograms to area of right triangles. And they've given you, or how to figure out the area of a right triangle. What they've given you here on page 2, I'm going to read this out loud to you, but we're actually going to skip this first part, and we're going to use the models to try to figure this out. It says, use the shapes labeled with a Y to predict the formula. Formula is like the equation, same thing, needed to calculate the area of a right triangle and explain your prediction. Well, before we explain it, let's take a look at the model. I'm going to scroll down, and we're going to look at the first model Y. Remember, area is how much space is inside of a shape. We have two options. We can either count up all the boxes, or you can give me the unit measurement for each side and then do what with the two sides? Multiply them. I think counting is easier. So how many boxes do you see? 9. Or it's a 3 by 3. So 3 times 3 makes 9, right? Okay. If I split it from corner to corner, I've now created two right triangles. Okay. Now what we can do is if this is 9 and I'm splitting this directly in half, what should be the area of one of the triangles? If it's exactly in half, what should the area of the triangle be? Yeah, say it, Sarah. 4.5. And we can prove that by counting. Here's one full box, right? Here's a second full box. Here's a third one. Well, watch. There's 3 complete ones. Do we agree? Then I have 3.5. 3.5 plus another half is 4 plus another half is 4.5. Or we could say 4.5. So now that being said, let's see if you can figure this out. If the area of a rectangle or square is base times height, what is the formula for the area of a triangle? Think about what you did when you went from this model to this model and see if you can apply that in coming up with the formula for the area of a triangle. We know rectangles and squares are base times height. What do you think? What do you think? Well, length times width still gets me the same thing as the area of a rectangle. But now we're doing triangles. Think about the relationship from here to here. Alexa, this was 9, right? Alexa, this was 9, right? What was the area of this triangle? 4.5. How does 4.5 relate to 9? Eric, what do you think? Okay, so see if we can work backwards. To figure out the area of a triangle, what is the formula? Come on, buddy. You can do it. You got derailed. Ricky, bail us out. It's the base times the height divided by 2. Is it 9 split in half or 9 divided by 2? Isn't that 4.5? Yes? A triangle is always going to be half the area of a rectangle. Well, the area of the rectangle is base times height. What's the same as splitting something in half? What's the same as multiplying by a half? Dividing by 2. Something to add? Go ahead, do it.
Have this shape. What is this shape? It's a square, right? Now, we're going to do exactly what was done here. So all I did is I took my square, and we have this now, right? Do you see that? We went from the whole to the half. don't make fun of my cutout here, my ripping. Okay, so do you see that? That's where you get the half. Here's the hole. That's why a rectangle is half of a square or a rectangle, depending on what the shape is. Do you guys see that? That's where you get the half.
Okay. And if you actually plug in the actual numbers, 3 times 3 was 9. That's base times height. And then we divide it by 2 or split it in half. What's half of 9? Okay, let's write it down. All right, so since the area is base times height, and since a triangle is half a rectangle or square, then the area of the triangle is half the area of the rectangle or square. It gets wordy, but more importantly is take that information and see if we can actually do it. I want to point out one more other thing, though, because you're going to see, I think that A equals base times height divided by 2 is an easier formula to work with. You don't have to deal with fractions. But if we have to use fractions, and you'll see there's one problem where we do, dividing by 2 is the same as doing what? Multiplying by a half. So you're going to see there's one instance where we got to do base times height times 1/2. It's coming up because you'll see if you – well, I don't want to jump ahead. You'll see what we mean. Okay. So let's put it into practice. Can I flip this page? We've come to our first triangle. It did? Well, you know what we did? It's 4.5. Right? It's 4.5? All right, you know what? I'll do it too. I'll model it. Because I still want you to use the formula. Okay, what was the base? No, not the area. What was the base? 3. What was the height? Also 3. Divided by 2. So that's what it's going to look like when you use substitution. So we're going to evaluate the top half. What's 3 times 3? And then 9 divided by 2 is half of 9, which is 4.5. 4.5 what? Square units. Because they don't give us whether the sides are measured in centimeters, meters, feet, or inches. So we just say square units. Okay? Okay, let's put it into play on the next page. Same thing like you were doing with parallelograms. Out of those 3 numbers, we only need 2 of them. There's a throwaway number. There's a trash number we don't need. Which number? Raise your hand, though. Which number is the one we don't need? James. 17, right? Yep. 17 is the throwaway. When you see that little right angle, we know we need the 2 sides connected to that right angle. Mrs. Singleton, do you have a question? Did you have something to add? Okay. So what's the formula, Jack, for the area of a triangle? Nope. Come on, think. That's the rectangle. What's the triangle? Go back and look at the page. Okay, let's write it. We've already determined that 17 is the throwaway number. That's the distractor. What's the base? Eric. Agreed. What's the height? Noah. Now you got to do the math. 15 times 8, don't make a mistake. Be careful. And then I'm going to show you the shortcut. Paul, 15 times 8. Y'all get 120? All right. Is my answer 120? You still have another step because you got to divide by 2. So now I got to take your 120, divide by 2, or split it in half. So what do you get? Okay. Okay. So here's the trick. I think it's easier to do it this way. And between your base and your height, one of those numbers happens to be an even number. Which one, the 15 or the 8? Okay, watch, ready? Watch this. Watch this. Take that 8, split it in your head. Split it in half in your head. What do you get? What's 15 times 4? Okay, it eliminates the division step. If you could take one of the numbers, either the base or the height, and split it in your head. I think it falls into the category of mental math. If you could split one of those numbers in your head, technically what we did is we reduced this 8 over 2 to 4 over 1. That's in essence what we did. 15 times 4 is 60, and any number over 1 is the numerator. Okay? Let me show it to you again. Separate page, but you don't have to write it. What if I tell you that the base is 7, and the height is 12. Is any one of those two numbers, oh, and by the way, it's a triangle, so we're going to divide by 2. Is any, which, 12 in your head, 6 times 7. The area of that triangle would be 42 square units. You don't, because if you knock out one of them, technically you did divisibility rules. 2 goes into both, 2 goes into 2 once, 12 goes into 2 goes into 12 6 times, and you're knocking it out that way. What about this? Here's where it really comes into play. It works out nicely. The 11 times 12 in your head may be difficult for some of you to do, but if you use the knockout rule, which one can be split in half? 11 times 6 is 66. Raise your hand if you think that's something that can help you. Okay? Now look, if that confuses you, you could still do it this way. 11 times 12, you'll get 132. And then 132 divided by 6, or divided by 2, will get you 66. It's just the longer way around. How many of you think you would use that strategy? Okay, can I just tell you one thing to be careful of? Sometimes students will do this. Tell me what I did wrong. Watch. What did I do wrong? Right, you can't do both of them. If you do both of them, you're going to get an answer that's actually half of the real answer. You can only do one. It doesn't matter which one you do if you're given two choices, because if I change this to a 6 and leave this 14, you get 84. If I leave this a 12 and make this a 7, you get 84. So whatever one you want to knock out, it's up to you. Totally your choice, but don't knock them both out, otherwise you'll be wrong. That's a good point. If they're both odd, like 13 and 11, guess what? You're stuck. You have to go the long way around. Well, if you do, you're not saving time, because you have to change 13 to 6.5. Now you got to contend with 6.5 times 11. It doesn't save you any time. Okay? It doesn't save you any time. But a good point. Thank you, Jack, for bringing it up. Okay. So let's, what are we up to? The first one? Okay, let's do this one. Okay, for this, I'll allow you to do calculators. Okay? Can I just show you one thing? Set it up. Don't get calculators yet. Set it up. Determine what your throwaway number is. And I'm going to have somebody come up and at least do the substitution, because I want to show you something. Don't grab a calculator yet, but do me a favor, James. Without doing the math yet, substitute everything that you need to in your formula. Write your formula. Substitute it, because, believe it or not, you have to be careful with calculators also. All All right, Mrs. Singleton's giving out calculators, but I don't want you to use it just yet. Just set it up. Here's something that I definitely think that we want to show you. Okay, stop there. Does everybody agree? 1.4 times 17.7 divided by 2. Okay, so if you're choosing to use calculators, here's what you should do if you want to do it all in one shot. In your calculator, everybody type in 1.4. Then times 17.7. And ready? We're going to do it all in one step. Divided by 2. You can do it all in one step, because what some kids will do is they'll take the 1.4 times 17.7. They'll get an answer for that, rewrite it. There's nothing wrong with that. But I'm showing you how you could do it in all one step. So it's always going to be first number times second number divided by 2. And truthfully, I would do it twice to be sure that you didn't make any mistakes. What do you get? 1.4 times 17.7 divided by 2. Hayden. Did you get 12.39? Did a good job. However, no naked numbers. What do we need? Square centimeters, cm squared. Good. Okay. Everybody do number 3 on your own. Do not do number 4. Okay, let's just... The tricky one with this one is it doesn't matter which orientation the triangle is. Notice it's rotated, so it's a little crooked, right? Always find the right angle, because the two adjacent sides that are cornering that right angle is my base and my height. So when you show this, it's area equals base times height divided by 2. And it does not matter what you call the base or the height. If you hold it up tall-wise, the base is 6. If you lay it down lengthwise, the base is 8. So I'm going to say 8 times 6 divided by 2. Did anybody do the knockout trick? Okay, so if you knock out 6, it becomes 8 times 3 is, who knocked out 8? Knock out 8, half of 8 is, 4 times 6 is, no matter what you knocked out, or even if you didn't knock out and did it the long way around, 24 square inches. Okay? Yes? We have one more to do together, and that's this one. Not that one. That one, number 4. Watch. Because this is one where I call this the watch out. First of all, what's the throwaway side? What's the throwaway number? So now we're left with a base of 8 2/3 and a height of 5 1/2. Why is this a dilemma if we're going to use, not that if we're going to use, but why is this a dilemma or an issue if we have been up to this point changing everything to decimals? Check. Yes, you have 8 2/3, which is a repeating decimal, and you cannot use repeating decimals when you multiply. So now we have no choice. We have to solve this, keeping them fractions. And I will tell you, is it a lot of work? Yes, it's a lot of work, but there's no choice. There's no shortcut. There's no shortcut. We're forced. Plus, we have to use the formula that involves the half, which was what? Base times height times. We have to use the one, though, with the half. Base times height times. Base times height times. Base times height times. Go back and look. Go back and look. Don't guess. Go back and look. Go look at page 2. Base times height divided by 2, or what was that other one? Base times height. That one, we need it. We need it because we can't change this to decimals. I know I just lost half of you. Because we have to leave this fractions. We can't take 8 2/3 and make it 8.33333 and go out the door with point threes and try to do math with it. You have to leave it as 8 2/3. And if you remember back to module two, when you multiply mixed numbers, what do you have to do first? I'll be amazed if you can remember this. Go back, put fractions back in your head. I know it's painful. You have to do something with mixed numbers before you can multiply them. Proper fraction. So, 8 2/3 improper. Remember, it's whole number 8 times the denominator. Thank you. Don't call out. 26 over 3. What is 5 1/2? But raise your hand. Sean? I need 5 1/2 as an improper. Over. Thank you. Okay. So now we wind up with what? A equals 26 over 3 times 11 over 2 times 1/2. What should I do next? Yes, we could cross reduce where? Very good. All right, well, let's do 26 and 2 first. What number goes into both? All right, 2 goes into both. 2 divided by 2 becomes a 1, and this becomes a 13. So now we got to do 13 times 11. Be careful, because 13 times 11 we'll get you the top half of the fraction. So now I got 143. What's 3 times 1 times 2? Come on, that you should be able to do. Am I done? No. Now what do I got to do? We already did that. We have to change it back into a mixed number again, because you can't leave it top heavy. So now I got to figure out how many times does 6 go into 143? I told you it's going to be a lot of steps, but it's our only way out. 6 can't go into 1, but it goes into 14. How many times? I don't want decimals. I want to leave it fractions. It's actually easier to leave it as a fraction than to try to change what we'll wind up with. 6 into 23. Only goes 3 times. Okay. I have a 5 as a remainder. And the denominator is 23 and 5, 6. Are we done? Tack on the units. All right, listen, this is, I know a lot of people, I lost a lot of you, but listen, this is why. First I want you to understand, can 8 2/3 be changed to a decimal? They can't. Not anything but a repeating decimal. You can't multiply a repeating decimal times another decimal. Can't do it. You won't get an exact number. So now you're forced, you have to keep them fractions. And therefore, you have to use the formula that's the fraction. Once you substitute everything in, guys, I hate to tell you, you're right back to what you did in module two. That's not the new part, it's the part that you forgot. Yes, it's extra steps. But at the very least, I need you to understand why you cannot use the second formula. You can't use base, or the first one. Base times height divided by 2 will not work. That'll only work if you can change them to what we call terminating decimals. Can't be repeating decimals. have to try it again tomorrow because we're out of time. Okay?